So, on the question as to whether you can fit sensors into your Tesla Model S and then not requiring Tesla to program them, basically I think the way it works, obviously you've seen my video when I changed them in mine and I cloned the existing ones, but a sensor in a wheel only has a frequency and a hexadecimal ID number. So as long as all the ID numbers are different, then the ECU in the car is going to read those ID numbers, and then once it's got that ID number, it can then read the temperature, pressure and battery status. So as long as you give them different ID numbers, I think you can make the car learn what they are. In the past, you used to have to program the ID numbers in the ECU in the car, but now cars have an automatic learning routine. So what I've done is fired up my scanner here, and the scanner will tell us what that learning routine is for a particular car. So we've got two 2014 ones. If I select the earlier 2014 models, which should then be the earlier ECU, and I go to relearn, there we are, it's got that manufacturer's name. So you might want to pause this video and then read this text. But this is the relearn routine, how to get the Tesla to recognize your sensors. So you should be able to get, you put the sensors in. To be honest, I can't see what this is saying because I'm looking at the back of a camera, but I think you basically do a reset on the screen on the Tesla, and then it should learn, once you're driving, it should then learn the ID numbers of the sensors. So let's compare this to 2014 to 2022. This should then be the Continental. Yes, as you can see there, that's focusing. That's the Continental ECU. And I'll just scroll through this text so you can see the relearn for that as well. And many websites, they will sell you a set of coded wheel sensors. You say the frequency, in this case it's 433 megahertz you need for the Tesla, which is the standard. And they will program a set of hexadecimal codes into them. So as long as they're all unique, which obviously they will, they'll just program four codes for you, then the sensor will, the ECU in the car will relearn them. So I think it's a relatively easy job. If they want some numbers, refer back to my video I made and just copy the hexadecimal numbers here of my car. We'll have no problem at all with that. But I think the hexadecimal number really doesn't matter. As long as all four are different, it doesn't make a scrap of difference what that code is. So I think it's an easy enough job, but I've never done it myself. The only time I've worked with TPMS sensors was that video I made where I changed my sensors and I cloned the existing ones. And then shortly after, I had another fault in the car and Tesla ended up changing the ECU out to the Continental one and consequently threw all my sensors away, even though they were only about 3 months old at the time. I asked for them back, but they said too late, already gone in the bin. Because I could have just coded those to match, and actually they could have coded their ECU to match my sensors, but you know what they like, they don't do anything other than replace parts for new parts. So they threw all my sensors away and I've now got Continental sensors in my vehicle, which is a shame because these Autel ones, you can program them, so I could have just, you know, wiped them and used them in another vehicle at some point. So yeah, that was £100 and something that I'd wasted there. But anyway, I hope that helps. So yeah, TPMS sensors aren't complicated, but the problem is there's a lot of tyre places, they don't really understand this technology yet. It's pretty simple, you've just got four sensors, hexadecimal code, and you've got two types of frequency. As long as it's on 433 megahertz, the ECU will pick it up. So it's not a difficult thing at all, but a lot of tyre places just don't understand it yet. Don't get involved in programming sensors. It's not an expensive bit of kit. You need to do it. So yeah, I think your best bet is go online, buy a set of four sensors, 433 megahertz, get them all coded to a unique ID number, whack them in, run through that learning routine, and you should be fine.